If you feel like your ATC is moving too fast or too slow, you can adjust the speed with two flow control valves on either end of the cylinder. Your limitation will always be how much air you can get out of the cylinder. So if you feel like the ATC is extending too slowly, you should open the flow control valve closest to the ATC by a quarter turn. If you feel like it is retracting too slowly, you should open the furthest flow control valve a quarter turn. Turning it counterclockwise opens the valve, while turning clockwise closes the valve. Once the speed is adjusted to your satisfaction, lock the valves into place by turning the interior knobs clockwise. To access the solenoids, remove the ATC side cover by loosening the hex screws through the holes and then sliding the cover off. These solenoids control the pneumatics. The solenoid closest to the front is the power drawbar cylinder. The middle solenoid is for the ATC carousel sensor, and the rear solenoid is for the tool blast on the tools of the ATC. All three are the same model, so you can swap them around to troubleshoot issues. To remove the solenoids, remove the two screws and disconnect the air lines. To remove the air lines, the air compressor has to be off and the air bled from the machine. Then use two fingers to push the retention ring in, while also pushing in the airline towards the fitting. Then pull the airline out. To reinsert the airline, just push it back in and the retention ring will clamp it securely. Underneath is an ATC pressure sensor. You can take the boot off and adjust the screw inside if you get low pressure warnings, even though your compressor is working correctly and your regulator is set to at least 90 PSI. This is your USB cable for communication to your ATC control board, and this cable is the connection for the optional foot pedal control. This cable powers the ATC controls. This rear panel is a pneumatic system brake module, which is specific to the MX machines. When you activate the power drawbar, the solenoid actuates, causing air to flow through this line to this regulator. It then reduces the air pressure from 90 PSI to around 10 PSI, which then activates the power drawbar at a lower pressure. Once the spindle orients the tool to the correct direction, the regulator will then send air to these airlines to hold the spindle in that position, as it has greater torque than the motor. This is an additional solenoid that is normally closed. When you open the gripper in the BT30 tool, this solenoid opens to allow the full pressure from the power drawbar cylinder to actuate and to release the tool to complete a tool change. If you have an issue where the tool orients and then immediately drops the tool before the carousel moves over, this can be an issue with the solenoid where it's sticking. On the rear filter regulator lubricator, or FRL, for the initial fill of air tool oil, you need to turn off the air or shut the pressure knob so that the gauge reads zero. Then you can unscrew the bottom right container. Fill the container about 2/3 to 3/4 full of air tool oil, then screw it back into place. Finger tight is good, otherwise it can crack. To set the correct airflow on the ATC's FRL, make sure the air compressor is set to 90 PSI. On the FRL's regulator, lift the adjustment knob and set the air pressure to 90 PSI. Resecure the regulator's adjustment knob. Under the ATC side cover, is the blast tool solenoid. When you press down on the solenoid release button, the air blast will be activated. Hold this down to allow air to flow through the FRL and start twisting the oil flow knob connected to the dome. Oil will fill into the dome. Observe the oil dripping in the center of the dome and adjust the knob until the oil is dripping between 1 and 2 drips per minute. The FRL oil flow will then be set correctly, and you can release the solenoid button. If you're having issues with the sensor, on Path Pilot, make sure the tray in light comes on when the carousel is at the end of the travel. Make the necessary adjustments so that the sensor has a clean line of sight.